In this next Dear Diary episode, we have... Story of Junko, and I met her in university at the Japanese Society. The bunch of us attended it. Sachiko was in charge of the... Junko, I think, was in command of, was third in command of the society. I found her to be extremely attractive, and I wasn't hesitant in telling her that I thought she was the most beautiful girl on St. Mary's campus. The most beautiful Asian, most beautiful girl, period, on St. Mary's campus. And I still tell her that every Christmas time when I contact her, I still tell her that. I was very much interested in being her boyfriend. I did pursue her. But she seemed really mechanical, like a woman made out of, like a female machine. She did not seem to be interested in anyone at all. And it's most unusual that here was a Japanese girl that did not look at guys. So one time, you know, well, the closest I came to being in a date with Junko was at a bus stop. She was on her way to a government office so she can get a social insurance number so she could work in Canada. And I had met her at the bus stop, and I was thrilled to no end that this girl, this most beautiful girl on St. Mary's campus, was at the bus stop that I was at. And I decided, well, I'm going to increase my friendship with her and talk to her. And we got along quite well, as we always did. But it wasn't until one day at the Japanese Society, we held sort of like a Thanksgiving Day dinner dance, or a maybe Halloween dance, I can't remember which it was, but it was for the Asian students, and the society, Japanese Society, was the host. So we went to this place, which was divided between a bar and a restaurant, and I had, of course, stay in the restaurant part. And I believe the place was called Pacifico down on Barrington Street. And a lot of Asians met there. It was the hangout for Asians. And I noticed that for the first time ever that when Junko was around the other girls at the party or danced with the other girls, she wouldn't dance with another guy, but she always danced with the other girls. And I noticed that her pupils would become enlarged when she was with another girl. And she would be totally entranced with this other girl that was dancing with her, to the point of she seemed like she was studying the other girl's face. And then I realized, you know, doesn't that seem odd to you? And then I realized that, you know, Junko is gay. She's not interested in guys. And right there then, it was over, and I realized, how is this that the most beautiful girl on the campus, period, hands down, has to turn out to be a lesbian? And then she never hooked up with a guy ever, and we still stay in contact every Christmas time. And that's the story of my pursuit of Junko, who she did go on to Boston. Boston University to finish her degree. She wanted a master's. I believe it was in business, master's in business. And then she went back to Japan. What a loss.
my sleep. I'm walking in the sea. From the mountains of fame. To the river so deep. I must be looking for something. Something sacred I lost. But the river is wide. And it's too hard to cross. Even though I know the river is wide, I walk down every evening and stand on the shore. I try to cross to the opposite side so I can finally find what I've been looking for. In the middle of the night, I go walking in my sleep. Through the valley of fear, to a river so deep. I've been searching for something, taken out of my soul. Something I'd never lose, something somebody stole. Walk anymore. Hope it doesn't take the rest of my life until I find what it is I've been looking for.